Hello. Hello. I'm the daughter of Morris and Eva Purnell. The late Eva Purnell, my mother, Evangelist, was one of the lead singers and the inspirational singers. I want to personally thank the family for giving me this opportunity to speak on behalf of my mother and to represent my family. When I learned that my mother would be crossing over, the very next day, I was thinking that it was important that my mother needed to hear the voice of Dawson. Now, my brother and my sister had access. It was COVID, and they live in Chicago. And I called my brother and I said, Dawson needs to talk to mom. Can you make that happen? And he did. And I don't know exactly what Dawson said, but I'm thinking this song comes to mind. You are my friend. You might not say a word, but I see your face, so I hear your voice, knowing you care. Dawson cared for my mother. My mother cared for Dawson, as they loved each other. As long as I know that Dawson is probably her oldest and her dearest friend who has weathered the storm. And so, winter, spring, summer, fall, all they had to do was call one another. And I'll be there, yes, I will. You got a friend. So whether my mother was singing or it was Dawson was playing somewhere, needed a vocalist or someone to speak at his church, it was never if I feel like it or it was something that they did. It was like, if you need me, call me. No matter where you are, no matter how far, I'll be there in a hurry. It was never an option. If they could get there, they were there. I remember I planned an event at my cousin's church on the west side of Chicago, and it was the Brown family reunion, and my mother sang a song in the morning, and Dawson looked at my mother. He was just such a love in his eyes, and he cried. And later on, my mom was saying she was specifically singing to him. And it was just something very special, very like in a zone, a friendship zone that was forever. And friends are friends forever, if the Lord of them. And they sure shared the love of the Lord and his word, and they loved singing. And I thank God, then thank you, Dawson, for making so that a generation not yet born will still hear my mother's voice because of your vision and because God predestined before the foundation of the world that you guys would work together and to glorify his name with music. I kind of think that before someone crosses over, they have an opportunity to like hang around and get some things ordered or just see something. And I imagine that if my mother peered in and looked at you, she would say, "Thank you for being a friend." Although she's gone away, what we have and what we share, because we have received Jesus Christ as our Lord and personal Savior, is the one thing that doesn't change. We are in the winter of your years and things are changing, but the one thing that does not change is God's love for us and his availability to us. I want to thank you for letting my family, my mother, taste and see God was good to see God up close in your life. And I thank God for that you shared the love of hymns. And I can imagine one day maybe you'll sing it together and you'll sing, "What a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear." What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. And I want to share this a gift from me to you. And it's a poem. I wrote it for my mom and dad, but I want to share. This was 40th anniversary, but I'm thinking about you too. It says, you have been weatherized by the Prince of Peace. You've been treated to endure all seasons. You have been marinated by grace. You have been salted to a heavenly taste. You have been through the rinse cycle of mercy. Your fabric has been brightened and your fibers are strengthened. You have been refined by the fire of the Holy Ghost. You are a rare and lively stone, Dawson. Dawson, you have been conditioned through trials to run the race. Dawson, you have entered the zone that leads to the resting place. Dawson, you have entered the winter of your years through the Ancient of Days by his amazing grace. Dawson, you blossom like spring and summer is perpetual. You have become a living epistle that is easily read. You have revealed the truth of what he said by the life you have led. Dawson, your presence is a sweet delicacy among us. And we look at you as my mother looked at you and talked to you. And she can taste and see that God is truly good. Thank you for loving my mother. Thank you. I know I went over the time period I was at given, but thank you for this privilege on behalf of my family. Happy birthday, and may God bless you to fulfill, continue to fulfill your purpose in the earth as long as He has you here. And I thank you for the music that you have given us that will live forever in our hearts and our soul, on media, and a generation not yet born will give Him glory. Because of the music that you released in the earth. God bless you. Thank you.